Okay, so today we are going to start with the chapter number 2, magnetic field. Same way as we have studied about the magnets in our earlier school days, that we have different types of magnets, okay? Like you have a bar magnet, you have a horseshoe magnet, and then the next type which we are having a control over, or we can have a control on this type of magnetic field, is called as an electromagnet. So electromagnets is something which we are using very widely in electrical engineering. Now, if we talk about this electromagnet, we have to understand some basic concepts about the magnetism, which are similar to the electric field. Now, you know that there is a two fields which we are basically going to discuss in the today's lecture. One is electric field and another is magnetic field. Now, what is the difference between the electric field and magnetic field? What are those terminology which are look alike or they are similar to the electric field terminologies in the magnetic field that we are going to study? But before going to that, we have to understand what exactly the magnetic flux is all about. What do you mean by magnetic flux density and magnetic field strength? And we all use this terminology for designing the magnetic circuits which are generally used in electric motors, transformer, and other electrical devices in which magnetic field plays an important role. Okay, so let's start with this basic concepts of magnetic flux. So what do you mean by magnetic flux? So magnetic flux, we start to understand this concept with the help of this bar magnet. We have a magnet in which there are two polarities are there, like north and south, you can say, and there are magnetic flux or magnetic lines of force which is starting from north and ending at the south. But similarly, if we take, instead of one bar magnet, if we take two bar magnet of the opposite polarity, and in between them we find that the magnetic lines are passing from one pole to the another pole, and this particular magnetic field, magnetic flux, is basically we are going to understand. So these magnetic lines of force which are passing by this particular blue plane, which it is visible on your screen, that plane, that particular lines, if we count those lines, then we are getting the value for magnetic flux. The magnetic flux is having its symbol like theta, and in that we will be having its unit as a Webers. So Webers will indicating the amount of magnetic lines which are passing by that particular blue plane. Now, if the plane is at 90 degrees or it at 0 degrees, or it has some angle between the lines as well as the magnetic field, then the magnetic flux value is going to change. Now, this is very important to understand. Say, for example, we are having a torch with us, and that torch is focusing a light, impinging a light on one particular area. And in that particular flow of light, if we keep one paper, and that paper is perpendicular, the paper is perpendicular to that light, then the minimum amount of light is encircled on the paper. But if that paper is not at 90 degree or not at right angle, it is having some slant or having some angle. And that time what happened? The circle at which the light is exposed to will be having a bigger area covered. But dear friends, the light will be the same, but the area is now increased. So the density of that light, or we can say the strongness, or we can say how bright that light will be, to wo kya ho jayega, wo yahan pe kam ho jayega. You will get a reduced amount of brightness if the paper or if that material is kept at some angle. And that's how here you can see that we have get a component of cos theta for our magnetic flux. So we have a magnetic flux having a unit as Weber's, symbol as phi, and then we are going to use this formula about the magnetic flux. Now it is not necessary that the magnets will be available in the same size. It will not be possible to have a magnet of the same strength all the time. So we have to identify some unit by which we can use that magnetic material, that particular magnet, in the form of our own requirement. Say for example, you might have seen at some places there are some cranes. Those cranes are lifting the heavy metallic equipments, or they are lifting the metallic equipments with the help of magnet. Now if that magnet is not having the strength, then that crane will not be in a position to lift that iron material. Now going ahead with this, as you see on the screen, that the angle plays an important role. So if you are calculating this magnetic flux, then we are going to see how to calculate magnetic flux density, and then we are going to find out what will be the magnetic field strength and what is the usage and what is the relevance of these all terminologies for our electrical engineering applications. So I hope you all are interested related with this. So just draw this diagram in your notebook. Done, everyone? Okay. Done, everyone? Now we have to see that this particular magnetic flux is what we are looking for in this area. 1 meter square ka jo area hai, uske andar kitna magnetic lines jo hai, wo pass ho raha hai, wo hame identify karna hai. And for that purpose, we are having this formula. Phi is equal to BA cos phi. Now, basically, this particular phi, where we talk about the magnetic flux, the unit will be Weber. B is a magnetic flux, magnetic field density, basically, or we can say the magnetic field in the Tesla. And then we have the area, which is shown in the green color. Okay, it is in the unit of meter square. And that's how we are going to find the value of magnetic flux, which is in between the two magnetic poles. Now, there is one point to understand, that when we talk about this magnetic flux, there should be always a flow. It means, agar aapke aap 10th floor pe hai aur aapne wahan se kuch object niche feka, to wo object definitely kahan pe aane wala hai? Ground floor pe aane wala hai. But that has a another level. Similarly, यहाँ पर भी क्या होना चाहिए? जो magnetic field one point से निकल गया, तो दूसरे point पे जाके क्या होना चाहिए? पहुँचना चाहिए. And that's why we are having these magnetic lines and we are calculating the magnetic flux which is flowing between the two magnetic poles. इतना समझ में आया आपको? So write down this formula and its information in your notebook. Next, we are going to have some calculations after understanding 2.3 or 2.4 of this particular chapter. So just type done in the chat box if you have done with the writing this formula and the details. Okay, moving ahead. Now, this particular magnetic field strength is also associated with the magnetic flux density. Now, we have another option to understand this concept. Like, if you are at a, जैसे कि generally ये example जो है, वो मैं आपको आपके physical classroom में देता हूँ. So now you just understand that you are sitting in the classroom. शायद आपने last time आपके school में ही बैठा होगा classroom में. तो वहाँ पे आप सब लोग 50-60 students बैठे हैं. ऐसा imagine करो. And then suddenly आपको बताया गया कि आपको आपके क्लासरूम से बाहर जाना है. सो नाउ व्हाइल यू आर गोइंग आउट ऑफ द क्लासरूम यू हैव अ सिंगल डोर, राइट? जस्ट टाइप यस इफ यू रेजोनेट विद दिस. सो यू हैव अ सिंगल डोर इन द क्लासरूम एंड यू ऑल ट्राई टू गो आउट एट अ वंस. सो डू यू थिंक इट इज पॉसिबल टू go all the students, 60 students at once? No, it is not possible. So we have to go by, say, two or three students one by one like that. Or agar bahut jyada bheed kiya, to we have like five students in the door. Agar samajh lijiye ki us door ko humne tod ke thoda bada bana diya. Okay? Now what happened? Now instead of only going or passing the four students, now we can have 8 to 10 students which can go through that door easily. Now you understand the difference between these two. That in earlier case, the area of the door is small, so less amount of students are going out. Similarly, if the area is increased, more number of students will go out. So similarly, just look at this diagram where we have two planes in which we have to consider the same area. Okay. Now we are not increasing the area here, but we are increasing the amount of magnetic lines of force passing through that particular area. Now in first area, we have lesser amount of magnetic lines. In second, we have more. So what happened? That particular area is getting the more crowded magnetic field, and then with compared to the earlier one. So now tell me, if we just say the names to these two planes as right one and left one, the right one has a more arrows, left one has a less arrows. So tell me, which magnetic field will be having a more strong or more strength?
Right.
Yes. So right one will be having a more magnetic strength, and that is what we are considering is along with the magnetic flux density. Is that flux per unit area. Now what do you mean by unit area? This is the same area which we are considered in earlier case. Jaise 1 meter square humne yahan pe consider kiya tha, uske according yahan par bhi hum kya kar rahe hain, ek unit area ko, ek common area ko identify kar rahe hain, aur hamare magnetic field ki jo taakat hai, magnetic field ki jo strength hai, wo hum yahan pe identify kar rahe hain. To iske pehle jo aapne formula likha, phi is equal to ba cos theta, similar formula hai, b is equal to phi upon a. So phi upon a kya hai? Phi is your magnetic flux, or a for area. Abhi area inhone directly liya hai kyunki the angle jo hai wo hai aapka zero, and because you know cos zero is one, to aapko kya milta hai yahan pe, jo area hai wo total area aapko मैग्नेटिक फील्ड को, मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स को पास करने के लिए यहाँ पे अवेलेबल है. नाउ दिस इज अ रेक्टेंगुलर शेप, बट सेम रेक्टेंगुलर शेप कैन ऑल्सो बी इन द वराइटी ऑफ फॉर्मेट लाइक सर्क्यूलर और ट्रेपोजॉइड और हेक्सागोनल लाइक दैट. वॉट एवर द एरिया विल बी दैट वी डोंट हैव टू कंसिडर इट्स शेप, बट वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द वैल्यू ऑफ एरिया इन द मीटर स्क्वेयर, in the unit of meter square. Okay, so I hope this point is clear to everyone. So write down this formula also, B is equal to phi upon A, where B is the magnetic flux density, the second point, and phi is a magnetic flux and A is the area. Going ahead with this, the number of magnetic lines of flux per unit area passing through a plane perpendicular to the direction of the lines is called as a magnetic field strength. And you have to write down this definition in your notebook. Go ahead. ये जो हम point अभी सीख रहे हैं, that point is important for the design of the inductor. Electronics field में inductor, capacitor, ये जो elements है उनका काफी ज्यादा importance है, और वो आपको आपके higher semesters में, आपके career में अच्छे से समझने के लिए ये जो topic आज हम discuss कर रहे हैं वो आपको तभी आपके फ्यूचर में काम आने वाला है. सो मेक श्योर यू पे प्रॉपर अटेंशन एंड राइट इट डाउन ऑल दिस थ्योरी पार्ट इन योर नोटबुक. व्हेन डन जस्ट टाइप डन इन द चैट बॉक्स.
डन सर.
ओके, सो नाउ वी विल हैव अ स्मॉल न्यूमेरिकल. राइट डाउन फॉर आई विल जस्ट शो दैट इमेज टू यू. आई विल शो यू गिवन डेटा टू यू. Is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Go ahead. Find the missing term. Missing term is phi. Phi is your flux. one point you will not understand here, that is n. N is nothing but your number of turns. तो अगर हम एक बार मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स फाइंड कर रहे हैं एक टर्न के लिए, एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू आइडेंटिफाई द मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स फॉर द टोटल नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स, देन वी हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई सिंपली दैट नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ दैट अमाउंट व्हाट वी रिसीव्ड. ओके, तो क्या करना है, इफ यू हैव द फॉर्मूला फॉर द फाई, आपने पहले उसका फॉर्मूला लिखा है, फाई का फॉर्मूला, तो वो फाई के साथ एन को क्या करना है, मल्टीप्लाई करना है. दैट द सिंपल थिंग टू गेट द आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. लेट्स सी इन द चैट बॉक्स व्हाट इज द आंसर. आई गिवन यू द हिंट आल्सो. What is the unit? So first we have convert the area. Area हमें चाहिए ना सबसे पहले. Now if you talk about the area, area will be always in the meter square. So have you considered that meter square? Have you considered which formula did you use?
Flux
is equal to
BA.
BA, but what? We have angle also, na? So ये वाला formula use करना था आपको, ये लिख के लिया आपने BA cos phi, इसको use करना है और B के साथ N भी जोड़ना है, मतलब N BA cos phi. Okay? Now A will be only, अगर आपने सिर्फ 0.3 meter लिया तो क्या होगा, it will be only meter. So we want meter square. Meter square के लिए क्या चाहिए? अच्छा, एक का ही आंसर आया अभी तक, ठीक है, आगे बाकी लोग का भी आंसर आने दो. लेट्स सी, हैव यू रिटन द न्यूमेरिकल इन योर नोटबुक? सो आई विल शो यू द फॉर्मूला वंस अगेन इफ समवन वांट. सी, वी हैव द 0.4 टी इज अ बी, ए इज 0.3 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 0.3, कॉस फाइव इज कॉस 60. ये सब कैलकुलेट करके देखो क्या आंसर आता है, एंड एट द एंड जो फाइव का वैल्यू आया उसको हमें 500 से मल्टीप्लाई करना है, बिकॉज वी आर हैविंग द नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स इक्वल टू 500. अभी नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स क्या होते हैं वो मैं आपको बताता हूँ थोड़ी देर में. मीनवाइल डू दिस कैलकुलेशन फास्ट. या 9 वेपर, यस सागर, परफेक्ट. सो दिस इज द सॉल्यूशन, दिस इज द गिवन डेटा एंड दिस इज द सॉल्यूशन. तो एन बी ए कॉस थीटा, 500 इज योर एन, 0.4 Tesla is your B, and A is 0.3 multiplied by 0.3 multiplied by cos 60. So we have this values, and at the end we get the value of 9 Weber. Okay, so I hope this point is clear to you everyone, how to solve these numericals. Okay, now going ahead with this, to understand what exactly these turns are all about, how the magnetic field is generated with the help of electricity, and what are the important points related with the turns and amperes. Okay, amperes ka matlab kya hai, just type in the chat box. Amperes ka matlab kya hai, what do you mean by amperes? Ampere ka matlab kya hai, current? Yes, current, yes, current flowing through your electromagnet. So electromagnet ke coil mein se jitna current pass ho raha hai wo current hame जानना जरूरी है, एंड वो मैग्नेटिक जो आपका इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट है उसके कितने टर्न्स है, कॉइल्स के कितने टर्न्स है वो जानना भी जरूरी है. सो इफ यू हैव दिस टू वैल्यूज, एन, एन इज नथिंग बट योर नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स, एंड ए इज एम्पियर्स और करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू द कॉइल, देन वी गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स एंड एम्पियर्स और एम्पियर टर्न्स. ओके, तो उसका मल्टीप्लीकेशन करके हमें ये मैग्नेटिक फील्ड का जो स्ट्रेंथ है, जैसे हमारे बैटरी में इलेक्ट्रोमोटिव फोर्स होता है, वैसे ही हमारे मैग्नेटिक फील्ड में या इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट में वी आर हैविंग मैग्नेटोमोटिव फोर्स. व्हाट इज द वर्ड? मैग्नेटोमोटिव फोर्स, विच इज सिमिलर टू इलेक्ट्रोमोटिव फोर्स इन इलेक्ट्रिकल सर्किट और इलेक्ट्रिकल फील्ड्स. मैग्नेटिक फील्ड में क्या होता है? मैग्नेटो मोटिव फोर्स होता है. ओके, सो आई होप दिस पॉइंट इज क्लियर टू यू, एंड वी हैव टू नाउ फाइंड आउट द मैग्नेटो मोटिव फोर्स विथ relation with your current and the number of coils. Meanwhile, you have generated a magnetic field and magnetic poles with the help of the coil along with some n number of turns, and the current which is flowing through that coil of certain amount or certain ampere. So I hope this point is clear to you everyone. So moving ahead with this, how to calculate magnetomotive force. Magnetomotive force matlab kya hai? Current jo hai wo coil mein se ja raha hai. I hope this visual is more related with this concept and you are understanding this. This coil is flowing the current through that coil and there are some number of turns. Turn number 1, turn number 2, turn number 3, like that. And this number of turns are considered for calculating the magnetomotive force. Okay, so write down this definition and this point in the notebook. What is this point? The MMF is generated by the coil. Magnetomotive force jo hai wo kya hai, coil ne generate kiya hua hota hai. Kaisa uska strength hum pata kar sakte hai? With the help of number of turns and the amperes which are flowing through it. So iska jo unit hai, that is 80 ampere turns. So write down this formula also in your notebook. And now we have to convert or we have to connect these electrical parameters into the mechanical or magnetic parameters. Ye dono ko abhi hame kya karna hai? Jodna hai. Kaise jodna hai? Let's see. Magnetic field ka jo formula hai, that is your B is equal to phi upon A, and magnetomotive force ka jo formula hai, that is MMF is equal to NI or ampere turns. Ye uska kya hai? Unit hai, jaisa aap abhi screen pe dekh rahe ho. So I hope everyone has written. Just type done in the chat box if you are done writing down and drawing this diagram. Okay, perfect. So now moving ahead with this, there will be a simple numerical on this in which the turns will be given and the current flowing through the coil will be given and you have to ask for MMF. Okay, kafi simple formula hai, kafi aasan hai. Dekhte hai abhi in dono ke beech mein kya relation hai, MMF aur EMF ke beech mein. जैसे आपका बैटरी होता है, बैटरी सोर्स होता है, वो आपके बैटरी में जो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स प्रेजेंट है उनको वो चार्ज अप करता है और फ्लो करने के लिए फ्लो करने के लिए अलाउ करता है, एंड द इलेक्ट्रॉन स्टार्ट मूविंग, द करंट स्टार्ट्स फ्लोइंग, करंट गेट्स एस्टैब्लिश्ड एंड करंट इज गेटिंग बैक टू द ईएमएफ. सिमिलरली यहाँ पे क्या होता है, मैग्नेटिक फील्ड में we have a MMF, that is magnetomotive force. It is created, it is creating the terminals north and south. ये दो poles बन जाते हैं, magnetic poles, और magnetic poles के जो field के जो lines हैं वो north pole से निकल के south pole तक पहुँचते हैं, and ये जो उनका flow है वो maintain रहता है. अगर इसके बीच में कोई magnetic material आ गया तो वो magnetic material इस मैग्नेट के कांटेक्ट में अट्रैक्शन होके क्या हो जाता है, वहां पे उसको वो नजदीक आके उसके साथ जुड़ जाता है. ओके, अभी ये डिपेंड करता है कि ये मैग्नेटिक फील्ड कितना प्रभावशाली है, कितना उसका स्ट्रेंथ जो है वो ज्यादा है, और उसके अकॉर्डिंग यहाँ पे जो एन एंड आई जो है वो क्या होता है, डिफर होता है. मतलब अगर हमें एक मैग्नेट से एक 10 mm का या फिर 1 सेंटीमीटर का कोई ऑब्जेक्ट उठाना है तो हमें जितना मैग्नेटिक फोर्स लगेगा वो फोर्स अगर उससे कई गुना बड़ा मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल को लिफ्ट करने के लिए अगर आपको वो मैग्नेट यूज करना है तो हमें वहां पे उससे ज्यादा जो मटेरियल है, जो पर्टिकुलर MMF है और उसका जो स्ट्रेंथ है, एनर्जी है, वो क्या होने वाला है, लगने वाला है. सो वी रिक्वायर्ड दैट मच अमाउंट ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा अमाउंट ऑफ MMF इन दिस. सिमिलरली जैसे यहाँ पे वोल्टेज ड्रॉप होता है, पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस क्रिएट होता है, उसी अकॉर्डिंग यहाँ पर हमारे मैग्नेटिक फील्ड में जो अट्रैक्शन होता है और आपका जो मेटेलिक पार्ट है, मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल का जो पार्ट है, वो आपके मैग्नेट के तरफ अट्रैक्ट हो जाता है. सो आई होप दिस पॉइंट इज क्लियर टू यू, एंड वी आर गोइंग टू solve some numerical on this also. So give me a moment to share another formula, another diagram to you, where we have this circular coil. ये सर्क्यूलर कॉइल दिख रही है आपको? जस्ट टाइप यस इन द चैट बॉक्स इफ यू आर एबल टू सी दिस. ओके, सो दिस सर्क्यूलर कॉइल, सर्क्यूलर कोर हैज अ फ्लक्स फ्लोइंग थ्रू दिस कोर ऑफ द डेंसिटी बी एंड द करंट व्हिच इज फ्लोइंग थ्रू दिस कॉइल हैज अ एन नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स. द क्रॉस सेक्शन एरिया ऑफ दिस कोर इज कंसिडर्ड एज ए एंड द लेंथ ऑफ दिस कोर is calculated as a mean distance between this core as L. Now MMF is equal to NI, H is equal to NI upon L, B is equal to pi upon A, and B is equal to mu H. So these are the formulas, you have to write it down, and I'm going to tell you what this H stands for and how we are going to use this H in our magnetic field. Okay, so just draw this diagram and write down these formulas in your notebook. Go ahead. Also, I am sending one definition in the chat box. So, usko bhi aapko aapke notebook mein likhke lena hai. Done, everyone? Okay, perfect. So, I will give you one link to understand more about this topic and variety of content link in that. Still, it is not exactly related with the syllabus, but still you are in a position to understand the variety of interesting thing about the magnets. So I'm sending that link in the chat box. Just open it and keep a bookmark in your in your Google Chrome or something. Okay, or I will just send you a link in the WhatsApp group also. Saloni will share that link in your unofficial group. Okay, so going ahead with this particular point, so we have seen that how to calculate this, and the numerical based on this will be considered in the next lecture. So aaj ke liye itna hi. I hope everything is covered properly and you understand it, and if you have any